Yes, it's Rasko and Disco beer review with me, Disco. Obviously, Rasko being the other side of London in lockdown, can't be here, so unusually it's just me on a video today. Rasko represented by my friend Percy the Penguin, because he represented me on his video with Ragdoll Disco the other day. So, Percy, I mean, Rasko is just gonna do what he does best, sit there looking cool and cute, and on this occasion, not say very much. You alright with that, Rasko? Cool. I got this. So, it's Sunday, I think. Yeah, Sunday. I've been waiting all week for this. As you can see, it's time for Sunday dinner. So, here I am at the dinner table. It's unusual that we do food pairings on Rasko and Disco, but I think it's only appropriate that we do a bit of food pairing. Unfortunately, my particular situation, being I've been in pretty much all week, I'm really down with this hashtag stay at home sort of thing, so I haven't actually got any of the constituent parts of a roast dinner. So the roast dinner here is going to be represented by this beef and smart pot noodle. I'm not going to eat that on camera because it's going to go everywhere, but that's representing that it's got all the some constituent parts of a roast dinner, a bit of beef flavour, tomato, some other vegetables in it. Much the same as this represents a roast dinner, being that the constituent parts in it made with Aunt Bessie's Yorkshire Puddings. And roast potatoes apparently in a mash there somewhere, I guess. And also seaweed. I think I know why that is, but I'm not entirely sure. But I've been looking forward to this all week. So let's get cracking. Let's get it in a glass and see what it tastes like. Gone for a straight pint glass. You know, nice and traditional, I think that. It's either that or a dimpled mug, but went straight pint glass. It's a brown ale, and brown it is, definitely. Nice, fairly creamy head on that, bit of carbonation there. Now, I'm not too good with aroma because my sense of smell is not that great. Nothing to do with COVID or anything, just it's never been that great. So it's got to be a really pronounced smell for me to take it. And it doesn't smell like a roast dinner. I don't suppose it's meant to. What it smells like is a brown ale, because that's what it is. And that's what it tastes like too, a really good brown ale. Now, I haven't got enough beer knowledge, I'm not intelligent enough to pick out any individual flavours there. So I'm not really getting any roast dinner. I'm sure it'll go well with a roast dinner or a pot noodle. I'm definitely not going to eat that on camera though, because that will go everywhere. Yeah, I've been looking forward to this all week. A little bit of hype around it, a little bit of expectation. Bit gimmicky, I suppose, you might say. I think it probably split a lot of people's opinions. But it is what it is. It's just a really good brown ale. And don't get too many of those, that kind of style, I suppose. But yeah, it's smooth. It's got those roasty, malty notes that a brown ale should have. I guess that's where the roast potatoes come in. I'm just going to sit and enjoy that. That's just a nice, very drinkable pint. Northern Monk. Come with a good beer. So that's part one. Part two, they've done a jam roly poly pale ale. Now, I'd normally go with that first and work up to the darker ones, but I'm going to sit and enjoy this decent brown ale for Sunday lunch, and I'll come back with some dessert. Was that alright, Rasko? He seems happy enough, as Rasko likes to say. But leave enough to lose control. See you later.